Malfoy knew about that necklace. It was on display at Borgin and Burke's.
But Katie was given the necklace in the ladies' toilet. How could Draco have put it in there?
Good luck today, Ron. I know you'll be brilliant.
I'm resigning after today's match. McLagan can have my spot.
Fine. Juice?
You look dreadful, Ron. Is that why you put something in his cup?
Don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, Harry. We've got a game to win.
You could be expelled for that.
You know what, Harry? I'm feeling really lucky today.
Have you tried out the jeweling club?
Hi, Nick.
Oh, Harry! Good luck today. Let's start the Quidditch season with a win, shall we? Here I am, talking away. You'd better get to the Quidditch pitch.
Good feeling about this match.
Can you cast Wingardium Leviosa?
Wingardium Leviosa!
Dashing Cadogan.
Oh, isn't Sir Cadogan dashing?
Would you like to stop and get that crest, Harry?
Wingardium Leviosa!
Well, well. If it isn't Potty Potter and Weasel King, you're going to lose today. Slytherin are supreme.
Leave this to me. I'm feeling pretty confident.
And now for you, Potter. Let's see how well you play Quidditch after you've been stupefied.
Sorry about that, Harry.
Yes,
listening, watching, blooding. Those Quidditch players, so noisy, so rowdy.
Oh, sorry. I'll ask my team to keep the noise down as they pass you.
You're one of them. A captain too. You might as well use my shortcut too. All the team captains do. My password is boiled beetles.
Thanks.
Let's go and beat Slytherin.
What's got into him?
He's just feeling lucky. Right, time for our pre-match warm-up. I've planned a few exercises that should help us get through. So, get your brooms and let's get flying.
You can practice it.
shouldn't have done it, Harry. Felix Felicis is illegal in organized competitions.
I suppose I should have just confounded McLagan and the trials instead. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me. Oh, and Ron only thought I'd given it to him. It turns out he can make his own luck.
Well, you won't need me to take him to Slughorn's Christmas party. And you'd better decide who you're going with. How does it feel when you see Dean with Ginny? I know, Harry. I've seen how you look at her.
Hermione, I'm sure Ron...
Oh, don't worry about Ron. He can make his own luck.
If her mind has got her knickers in a twist. What Lav and I have, well, let's just say it's chemical. There's no stopping it.
Suppose you're going to Slughorn's party?
Yeah. I better go. I'm meeting Luna down by the boathouse.
Luna? You could take any girl in the castle and you're taking Loony Lovegood.
Yeah.
1-1! Woohoo!
Have fun.
Have you seen Luna Lovegood anywhere?
Seen? No. Heard? Yes. I think I overheard her try to persuade the merman to look out for exploding snapper witches or dabber blimps or something. Ha! Oh, she's down by the boathouse anyway.
Hi, Luna. That's a nice dress.
Do you think I should wear my radish earrings as well? Can't decide if they go with me.
No, you look fine.
I'm glad you came. Professor Slughorn asked me to set these fireworks off to announce his party, but I'm not sure what you're supposed to do with them.
We just need to cast Incendio on their fuses.
Let's light the others. There's the... Whee! Here's another one. It's right. The chain fireworks don't last forever. It's supposed to light everything.
I solemnly swear that I am up to no good. Mischief managed. The auras have opened this part of the castle now. Come on, let's get a Slughorn's party.
I've been to this part of the castle in my sleep. I sleepwalk, you see. That's why I wear shoes to bed.
Harry, my boy, glad you came. There are so many people I want you to meet.
Professor Slughorn, there's no one else here.
Of course not. And a good job, too. We're not ready yet, not in the least bit ready. That's where I could do with a spot of help. I'm sure you and Miss,
Lovegood.
Here, we'll soon get the place in shape. I was going to rustle up a party punch for my guests, but time has not been willing. Could you mix something for me, perhaps?
Cherry syrup.
Aren't you? I think you should clear that smoke, my boy. Hurry, hurry, time. Please, leave us a little air in the room, Harry. Wakey, wakey! Steady on there, Harry, my boy. That's all the time you have. Wonderful, a nectar from the gods, a taste of sunshine and happiness. I knew you were the man for the job, my boy. Our guests are here.
Stop there, Potter. I only wish to convey a message. Professor Dumbledore asked me to give you his best. You see, he's traveling and won't return until term resumes.
Traveling? Where?
Take your hands off me, you filthy squib!
No, Mr. Filch. What is all this fuss about?
Okay. I was gate crashing. Happy?
I'll escort him out. What were you doing there?
I don't have to tell you anything. You shouldn't push me around.
I am trying. Get to your lesson, Potter. 10 points from Gryffindor for skulking about. What were you doing there?
I don't have to tell you anything. You shouldn't push me around.
I am trying to help you.
You just want to steal my glory.
Keep your voice down.
Lost them.
What were you doing there?
I don't have to tell you anything. You shouldn't push me around.
I am trying to help you.
You just want to steal my glory.
Keep your voice down.
Maybe I did hex that Katie Bell girl. Maybe I didn't. What's it to you?
I swore to protect you. I made the unbreakable vow.
I don't need protection. I was chosen. This is my moment.
Bloody hell. You don't think Snape was just pretending?
No, he even said he'd taken an unbreakable oath.
The unbreakable vow?
Yeah. What happens if you break an unbreakable vow?
You die.
Everyone gone to bed? I don't sleep these days, so I wash my hair. Silly, right? Happy Christmas, Harry.
Bellatrix!
Harry! Harry!
Hello, Harry.
Stupefy! Expelliarmus! Kago!
Thank you. Get away from her!
You're lucky you weren't killed, mate. Thanks for, you know, Ginny. If you'd not got there, I could have had a werewolf for a sister.
Yeah, no problem.
Dad said he checked Borgin and Burke's. He said Malfoy was looking at a vanishing cabinet.
A vanishing cabinet? What would he want with one of those?
Dunno. But Dad said it was still there in the shop.
He's up to something. I just don't know what it is.
Hi, Harry. Ron. Harry, I think Professor Slughorn is having another party for invited guests.
Slug Club? Maybe Slughorn can make you and Claggan King and Queen Slug. See you, Harry.
Hermione, have you seen Malfoy doing anything suspicious?
Oh, really, Harry? Are you still worried about Draco?
Ron told me his dad found out Malfoy was looking at a vanishing cabinet in Borgin and Burke's.
But there's no way he could sneak a vanishing cabinet into the castle. The Aurors are searching everyone who comes in. They're even checking the outpost.
Then you tell me how he disappears off the Marauder's map. I'll show you. I solemnly swear that I am up to no good.
Mischief managed.
He's there, in the 7th floor corridor.
So? He's not disappeared then, has he?
But sometimes he does vanish completely. I'm going to find out what he's up to. I'm going to the 7th floor.
What's that I hear? Sounds like a scoop to me. Hot news goes cold fast. You better use my shortcut. Just say, happy headlines.
Do you really think you'll find anything, Harry?
Yes, I'll prove he's up to something. Happy headlines.
I bet there'll be loads more with you in, eh?
Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa!
Hey, Ron, have you seen Malfoy?
When?
Just now. He's always hanging around on this corridor. And I just found this. It looks like instructions for a potion.
It's probably homework.
And since when has Malfoy put effort into homework?
You don't even know it's his.
I'm going to ask Hermione what this potion is. I bet that will give us a clue to what Malfoy is up to.
You're in luck. She's swatting in potions now. Careful, she's still in the right mood.
So you won't come with me then?
I think I'd rather face that troll we saw in our first year. See you later.
Hi, Nick. Have you seen Hermione anywhere?
Why, yes! Miss Granger is studying in the potions classroom.
Libraries Liberate.
And so they do, and so they do.
Hello, Hermione. Do you recognise this potion?
I'm surprised you don't recognise it, seeing as you're top in potions. It's obvious what this is.
So, what is it?
Why ask me? You should ask the Half-Blood Prince.
All right, I will. Well, I can make the potion and find out anyway.
Shredded Boomslang Skin. Unlucky Boomslang.
Stewed lacewing flies. Yeah.
back again, are we, Harry? And a splendid polyjuice potion you're making. But I do hope you're not intending to take it. It is a restricted potion.
You're sure it's polyjuice, sir?
Of course, that grey and sludgy finish, all characteristic. But then you should know, my lad, you made it.
I was just experimenting. Thanks, sir. Polyjuice potion? You use that if you want to look like someone else. I wonder what Malfoy would want with that.
Voldemort isn't going to trust Malfoy with a mission. You haven't got a scrap of evidence, have you?
No, not yet. But I'll get something.
Dumbledore wants you to go to his office for another lesson. Harry, when you see Dumbledore, don't say anything about Malfoy.
He's up to something. He's sneaking around and he's even ditched Crabbe and Goyle.
Yes, I admit that is out of character. But you don't have evidence that he's doing anything.
If he's not, then why is he sneaking around the seventh floor and... The seventh floor? That's it! He's using the Room of Requirement! That's why he keeps disappearing off the Marauder's map.
Well, if he is using the room, you won't be able to see what he's doing in there. That's why we used it for DA meetings. Concentrate on your lesson with Dumbledore. He's waiting for you in his office.
Are you there, Nick?
Well now, Harry. Off to see Dumbledore. I think he's in his office, though he has been away from the school rather a lot.
Morning, Harry.
Professor Dumbledore. I am too.
Are you all right? Come on, what's the matter?
It's silly. A Slytherin stole my gobstone. It's a noisy hitter my mum got me for Christmas.
Who was it?
Him.
Wait here. I'll get your gobstone back. Hey, did you take a noisy hitter from the girl over there?
What's it got to do with you?
Give it back.
What are you going to do? Jinx me? I'm sure Professor Snape would love to know you've been jinxing Slytherins. He might even give you detention.
Stupefy! Stupefy! Belly up!
There. Now hand over that noisy hitter.
I hope it gobs all over you.
And next time, think twice before you bully someone. Here you are.
Thanks. Harry, you're the best.
Acid Pops.
Good evening, Harry.
Professor, about Malfoy and... Snape.
Professor Snape. I've told you, Harry, I trust Severus. My answer has not changed. Now, to the business at hand. I have not been able to find many memories of Tom Riddle at Hogwarts. I did, however, find this one.
Good gracious, look at the time. Off you go, boys. Lestrange, Avery, don't forget your essays. Look sharp there, Tom. No, Tom, I don't know anything about Horcruxes. And I wouldn't tell you if I did. Now get out of here.
I don't understand. What happened?
Professor Slughorn has tampered with his memory. Harry, I asked you to get to know Professor Slughorn. Now I want you to persuade him to divulge his true memory. Any way you can. That memory is everything. But I believe you have Quidditch practice. You'll find your way there more easily now the orders have opened more of the castle. Good day, Harry.
I solemnly swear that I am up to no good. Mischief managed.
Hello, Harry. Professor McGonagall's looking for you.
Do you know what she wants?
No, but she's waiting for you in the Transfiguration courtyard. Sounded important.
Hermione and I are looking for Professor McGonagall.
Ah, Professor McGonagall is in the Transfiguration courtyard at the moment. You should make your way there.
McGonagall. She was rather insistent.
Ah, there you are. I wanted to talk to you after the unfortunate events at the Burrow over Christmas. Why is it always you? When something happens?
Believe me, Professor. I've been asking myself that for years.
I heard you've joined the dueling club, Harry. I think you should follow his example, and the Weasleys too. You can't be too prepared. Don't limit yourself to your friends in Gryffindor, mind. Ah, here's the person we were waiting for.
Hi, Harry.
Alanis here is captain of the Ravenclaw dueling club. You come along with me, Miss Granger, and we'll sign you up with Gryffindor dueling club.
Would you like to practice casting Levy Corpus with us? I've always wanted to learn that spell.
Okay. Levy Corpus!
Thanks for teaching us that. Be careful, though. You might find some Ravenclaws casting at you in future duels. Let's try a proper duel while you're here. Ravenclaw's junior champion against Harry Potter.
Thank you.
Thanks for that, Harry. As a special member's privilege, you can use that portrait shortcut over there. The password is light against darkness. Why don't you try our dueling challenge? Just go to the notice board when you're ready to give it a go.
I believe you're due at a Quidditch training session. I am rather hoping Gryffindor will win the Quidditch Cup this year. Get yourself along there, Potter. Great Quidditch teams are not built on tardiness.
Are you there, Nick?
Miss Ginny Weasley is waiting with the rest of your team down at the Quidditch pitch. I will hurry along and join them if I need.
Light against darkness.
Keep up the good fight!
Boiled beetles.
What? Yes, just don't tell them that.
Hello, Harry.
Where is everyone?
They're already out practicing.
Great. Can you help me with some seeker practice?
Well done, everyone!
Personally, I think we need a better defence. The other teams have got really good keepers. We haven't that luxury.
Ron's doing better than you could, McLagan.
Just offering some friendly advice. One keeper to another.
Well, take your advice out of our training room. You're not on the team, McLagan.
Hello, Harry. Are you ready for potions? I've looked. But I can't find anything on Horcruxes in the library. I've been thinking. Maybe, if you make a really good potion in today's lesson, it will put Professor Slughorn in a good mood. Then he might tell you what he's hiding from Dumbledore.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Oh no! McLagan? He makes Grawp look like a gentleman. I'll see you in potions.
Hey, Granger! Granger!
So, is she seeing McLagan?
Well, they went to Slughorn's Christmas party together, but it didn't go well.
Yeah? Come on, let's go after Hermione. Let's go to potions.
Hello, Potter. I'm a member of the finest dueling club in Hogwarts, Slytherin. We've noticed that you're quite the duelist. I therefore permit you to challenge me to a duel. No thanks. We're on our way to potions. I'm not asking you, Potty. I'm telling you, stupefy!
Demi Corpus! Stupefy! Expelliarmus!
I didn't really try anyway. Come along to our dueling club in the paved courtyard for a real challenge.
Why is Slytherin such bad losers? Come on, let's go to potions.
Incendio!
Stop it! Stop flying round! Come back down here!
Harry! You've got to get rid of her, Harry.
I thought you were going out with her.
Yeah, I am. But please, just tell her I flew into a wall in Quidditch or something.
What's the matter?
Someone's done something to my books. And the stupid things won't stop flying around. Come down!
Right. Have you tried anything other than shouting at them? Like Wingardium Leviosa?
No. I wish Wonwon was here. He'd do something. Have you seen him?
No. Here, if I cast Wingardium Leviosa on your bag, I can try and catch the books in it.
You've got one! Get in the bag, you books! Thank you. Wonwon used that book to do his homework. You're almost as good as Ron! Thank you. Are you sure you've not seen Ron?
Yeah, I have. He was in the divination tower.
Why would he go there? He doesn't do divination anymore.
He said he wanted to ask something important about his future.
It must be about us. That's why I like my Wonwon so much. He's always thinking about us.
Thanks.
Are you ready for potions? One.
Pack it in.
Quickly now, quickly. We have lots of work to get through, starting with antidotes. Now, what about this poison here? Any suggestions? Miss Granger, of course.
It requires a very complex antidote, but I think you should start with a drop of castor oil.
Good. Harry, my boy, any suggestions?
Yeah. You could do that. Or you could just shove a bazaar down the victim's throat.
Yes. A bazaar would certainly do the trick. Excellent, my boy, excellent. A good potion maker always knows how to counteract the potions they are making. Which brings us to the task at hand. Brewing an elixir to induce euphoria.
Can induce excessive singing and nose tweaking if you don't put enough peppermint in. Mint spritz. Shrivel fig.
Porcupine quills. Wormwood.
Leave us a little air in the room, Harry.
Sir, you knew Tom Riddle, didn't you?
Mr. Riddle had many teachers whilst here at Hogwarts.
I know, sir. You must get fed up of questions about Voldemort and Horcruxes.
I'd ask you not to talk about this subject.
But, sir...
Dumbledore put you up to this, didn't he? Didn't he?
I just want to know about Tom Riddle.
You're going to give me a bazaar? I need a good mark in potions.
I had to soften Slughorn up so I could ask about Voldemort.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna get something to eat.
McGonagall wants to see you in the astronomy tower.
So why would she send someone from Slytherin?
I'm not your personal messenger. Go and ask her yourself.
But the Aurors shut the astronomy tower.
Then they've obviously reopened it, haven't they?
I solemnly swear that I am up to no good. Mischief managed. Have the Aurors reopened the astronomy tower?
I believe they have, yes.
Libraries Liberate.
Lumen Siccum.
Boiled beetles.
They're watching us. They're all watching us.
Is that a crest over there?
Potter?
A moron free view? Oh, too late.
You're the moron who's turned up to see someone who's not even here.
Malfoy sent that message.
Yeah, get him!
You get him!
Potato! Superfly!
Okay, come on then, Potter. Somewhere you won't find him.
You're not supposed to tell him that, stupid.
Doesn't matter. He won't get out of there, will he?
Thank you.
arrow!
So Crabbe and Goyle attacked you. What's strange about that?
Malfoy wasn't with them. Sometimes he's not even visible on the Marauder's map. Look!
You must be missing him. I mean, he can't just disappear, can he?
Maybe Hermione's right. Maybe I should forget about Malfoy and concentrate on Slughorn. But how am I supposed to get to his memory? I don't even know what a Horcrux is. Ron!
Beautiful, isn't it? The moon.
Yeah.
I can't stop thinking about her, Harry. I love her. But do you think she even knows I exist?
Well, she's been snogging you for months.
Snogging? I've never snogged Romilda.
Romilda? Ron? Did you eat these chocolates? They're from Romilda Vane. They're full of love potion.
Romilda. Do you know her, Harry? Can you introduce me?
Yeah, she's in Slughorn's office. Yes, she's definitely there. Follow me.
Hi, Ron. Have you done your potions homework?
Hermione, you're a girl.
I'm surprised you noticed, Ronald.
I think Romilda would like flowers or chocolates.
Don't mind him. He ate some love potion. I'm taking him to Slughorn's office.
To see Romilda? Ah, Romilda.